I don't know how often you guys wanted to color grade and make your footage look more film-like in DaVinci Resolve, but somehow you just got a little bit discouraged because you just don't have the time to really sit down and tweak all the individual knobs and dials to give it a certain look that you're looking for. In particular, I am talking about that real old-school filmic look. Fortunately, I have a plugin that works directly in DaVinci Resolve that will resolve all that. Pun intended. The plugin I'm talking about today is called DEHANCER Pro and it works specifically in DaVinci Resolve. I first stumbled upon the plugin a few weeks ago in Carlos Quintero's channel and I really was quite impressed with the whole plugin and how it gave your footage a very quick and simple way to grade according to film emulsions. Ironically, last week I got an email from them asking me if I would be interested to try out their plugin and post it up on my channel. So having known their plugin before this, I definitely jumped at the opportunity to give this plugin a try. However, just as a disclaimer, they didn't tell me what to say in this video, but they did give me a copy for making this video. Okay, so let me briefly explain what exactly you get with this plugin for DaVinci Resolve. The plugin comes with 9 different camera profiles you can choose from. As for film emulsion, you can choose from a list of 55 different film emulsion, and that's quite a lot. The film emulsion ranges from Kodak Vision 3 250D, Konica Vision 100 DNP, Polaroid, Polychrome 35, just to name a few. Also, this plugin allows you to add film grain, vignettes, halation, bloom, gate weave, film breathing, defringe, and a few other things I won't go into in this video. Okay, so let's first briefly go through the installation process for the plugin. It's really easy. Just go to the DEHANCER homepage and select the DEHANCER Pro plugin and download it. Once it has finished downloading, just double click it and decompress it and the installation software should begin. Just as a quick note, there are 2 versions of the plugin, one for the Apple Silicon Macs and the other is for Intel based Macs. So make sure you read the README file attached to the installation files and make sure you install the right version for your Mac. So once you have installed the correct version of the plugin, just go straight ahead and open up DaVinci Resolve. Right, so I thought it wouldn't be complete if I don't show you how to use DEHANCER's plugin. It's really easy, so all you've got to do is just open up DaVinci Resolve, and once you're in Resolve, bring in the footage that you want to bring into the media pool over here down here, the footage, just drag and drop them down here and bring it to the edit window, and also drag and drop the footage that you want to bring down here. In this case, I've already got the footage down here, so I don't have to do that. Now go to the color tab and scroll all the way down here in the library section here and go all the way down to the DEHANCER Pro 3.4.1. So all you've got to do is just drag and drop that onto the clip, so immediately by default it will actually color grade it into the Kodak Vision 3 250D, but you don't have to just use that. You have a selection of about 55 different film emulsions that you can use, so I'm just gonna have a look and see which emulsion I want to actually use. There's Agfa, and there's Kodak, there's Ambrotype, Astrum color negative, Cine Still, Fuji Eterna, and quite a lot of interesting film emulsions actually here. So okay, I'm just gonna select the Eterna Vivid, and now once you've actually put the film emulsion onto the clip itself, it doesn't just stop there. You can also adjust all these settings here. I'm not going to go into too much detail, but you can also change the black point so you can make it more contrasty, or the white point, you can make it more overexposed looking, like how film looks. And you can even change the color mode, whether it's luma, whether it's normal. Oh, also before I forget, for the source of the clip itself, you can change it between Rec 709, Rec 2020, a few other different sources here. Also, you can choose what camera you would like to make the source be. So maybe if you're shooting on a C200 or something like that, you can specifically tune the footage itself to be a camera that is actually sourced from these particular brands that they've listed here. So in this case, they have RE, Blackmagic, Canon, DJI, Fujifilm, Kinefinity, Panasonic, Red, and Sony, and DJI as well. So in this case, I'm just gonna try and put it into the Canon one, and I'm just gonna select it because they don't have any other cameras here. This was actually shot on the EOS R, but I'm just gonna select it as a C200 and select the format. So I'm gonna say BT709. So yeah, I'm quite happy with that. So now I'm just gonna adjust the other settings down here. I'm gonna try and see the exposure adjusted in this print section here, adjust the tonal contrast, color density, and also I want to scroll all the way down. So this is the part where I really like. They have the ability to actually give your footage film grain, and it's not just like typical noise in some plugins, you know. This is real film grain looking kind of noise. So you can change the size of the grain. So in this case, the size is really big, so it's looking really like an old film. Or you can adjust the size to be a bit smaller, and you can even adjust the amount of grain you want. So over here, if I adjust the amount of grain to be really a lot, you can immediately see it's looking really like an old film, you know. So I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna show you guys just an example, and you can even bump up the resolution. So I think what the film resolution does is it just adds some kind of sharpness to the image itself. So it it just adds sort of sharpness and definition onto the footage itself. So I kind of like that as well. So you can do other things as well. You can even add halation. So I mean, halation is kind of a bit like chromatic aberration in some ways, but you can't really see it that clearly unless you have a footage that is really contrasty. So in this particular image, it's not that contrasty, so you don't really necessarily see it that clearly. Anyway, let's try and go and see this footage. So I'm just gonna do the same thing. So every time when you open the footage that you want to give the DEHANCER Pro a film emulsion on, all you've got to do is just drag and drop the film emulsion onto that clip. So I am going to reduce the amount of strength. So over here, if you scroll all the way down, you select the output here, and then you can reduce the strength of the film emulsion on the footage itself. So I'm not going to give it full on because you kind of lose some colors here. So I'm just going to give it about almost halfway through, or a little less than halfway through. And I'm just going to adjust some of the other settings in here. So I am going to give this a bit of a film grain, and I'm going to adjust the chroma here a little bit, just give it some halation, diffusion. Again, you can't really see the halation that clearly if the image is not that contrasty. I mean, that's something that I discovered, but it does definitely appear if you have a very contrasty image that you can really clearly see those things. Anyway, let's scroll down here. I'm gonna go to vignette, and I have to enable vignette first for vignette to work, and I'm going to give it a bit of a vignette. And if you change the feathering, you can clearly see the vignette looking clear here, and if you feather it more, then it's gonna create that really nice kind of vignette all around. You can even change the aspect ratio of the vignette. So I'm just going to adjust the feathering so that you can actually see the different aspect ratio of the vignette. So you can change it to that, or you can change it to be very, very flat. So I'm just going to give it something a bit more like that, and I'm just going to adjust the size to be a bit bigger so it's just covering the edges, and I'm going to feather it out. And I am just gonna, if you go all the way to the positive side, then you're gonna get a very bright vignette on the side. So I'm just gonna cause it to be very dark on the side. And it gives you a maximum up to -2. So the vignette is not particularly super strong, but it does allow you to do vignetting. So that's really nice. It has film breathing as well. I'm not too sure what film breathing necessarily means, but I would expect it probably to be something to do with the way film actually looks, you know, while it's playing back. So I'm not gonna turn that one on. As it is, I am still trying to get used to this app or this plugin. So it has so many different features here that, you know, one would definitely have to explore all the specific different controls here. But anyway, I just wanted to show you guys a quick overview on how to use DEHANCER Pro. And just in case if you're wondering, so when you use DEHANCER Pro, you can still adjust your curves if you need to add, you know, your own custom sort of adjustments. So the beauty about DEHANCER is that you plunk the film emulsion on it and you can keep adjusting things from the curves to anything else, and you can literally make the emulsion look specifically like your own custom adjustment. And it's way more easier because you have a good starting point with using the film emulsion, so you don't have to start from square one to get that film look. So all you have to do is just select the film emulsion that you want and keep tweaking it, you know, if you still do want it to be, you know, a bit more customized. Yeah, and so yeah, that's basically it. I just wanted to show you guys how to use the plugin. It's really easy and I really find it so effective. It's one of those plugins that to me is really well worth getting. Right, so that's the DEHANCER Pro plugin in a nutshell. I really like how it works. It's so easy to use and the results are really, really nice. I'll definitely be using it more and more, I think, these days, especially when I want to get those filmic looks and LUTs and stuff like that. It is invaluable in my opinion. Anyway, it may be a little bit pricey, but for what you can do, I think it's well worth the money. Anyway, that's it for my quick review on the DEHANCER Pro. I hope you guys did like it, and if you did, please don't forget to give me a like, share, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.